Welcome to AHT. If you're looking for a fast and fun way to learn healthcare skills, then you've come to the right place. I'm Josh Farkason, and today I'll show you how to apply four simple rules for building medical terms of all sizes so you can spell them correctly. Let's begin. Everyday words and medical terms have similarities in structure. For example, joyful has the word root joy and the suffix full. The suffix full means full of, and the word root joy means happiness. Now, if we look at the medical term gastric, it has a similar structure. The suffix IC means relating to, and the word root gastro means stomach. Notice that when you define a medical term, you begin with the suffix, then define the remaining word parts from the start of the term and beyond. Let's separate the word parts in gastric and examine them closely. You may see words that have a slash and a vowel at the end of them. It's most common to see a slash O. This O is called the combining vowel. The role of the combining vowel is to help with pronunciation and spelling. The slash indicates that the combining vowel may or may not be required when connecting the word root to other word parts. I'll cover those situations with you in a moment. When you see the word root and a combining vowel together, it is called a combining form. Now let's examine the suffix. The hyphen shows where the rest of the word attaches. Therefore, the suffix attaches to the end of the word. When attaching suffixes to other word parts, you need to determine if using the combining vowel is necessary. To make this determination, follow Rule 1, which states, if the suffix begins with a vowel, do not use the combining vowel. Since the suffix here begins with the vowel I, we do not use the combining vowel. Rule 2 states that if the suffix begins with a consonant, use the combining vowel. Now let's put the rules into practice. Apply the rules to spell both terms correctly. The answer will appear in 3 seconds, so press pause if you need additional time to answer. And here are the answers. Great job if you answered correctly. Next, you will learn how to attach prefixes. Notice the hyphen placement on the prefix. This indicates that the prefix attaches to the front of a word. When attaching prefixes to other word parts, follow Rule 3, which states to attach prefixes to other word parts automatically. So here it doesn't matter if hypo or gastro begins with a vowel or a consonant. We will attach them automatically to form hypogastro. Now let's attach the suffix. Since the suffix begins with a vowel, we'll use Rule 1 to drop the combining vowel and complete the term hypogastric. Now it's your turn. Apply the rules to spell both terms correctly. The answer will appear in 3 seconds, so press pause if you need additional time to answer. And here are the answers. Great job if you answered correctly. Now let's move on to combining multiple word roots. Notice the combining vowels at the end of both word roots. Since we are attaching one word root to another, we will focus only on the combining vowel in between the two word roots. Rule 4 states to automatically use the combining vowel in between the word roots to link them together. In this example, we use the combining vowel in between the word roots to form nasogastro. Now let's attach the suffix. Since the suffix begins with a vowel, we will use Rule 1 to drop the combining vowel and complete the term nasogastric. Now you try. Apply the rules to spell the terms correctly. The answer will appear in 3 seconds, so press pause if you need additional time to answer. And here are the answers. Congratulations. In just a few minutes, you learned how to use 4 simple rules to build medical terms of all sizes and spell them correctly. Now, if you're ready to sharpen your skills, visit ahtlearn.com for more practice activities and resources. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. then share this video with others so we can continue to help as many people as possible. It was a pleasure teaching you today, and thank you for participating with me. I hope you stay blessed and keep striving.